We first heard about the plans to build this plant back in January 2007 when Ineos Chlor sent out leaflets telling people their plans. A public meeting was formed and hundreds of people attended it locally, and at that time a group of people were elected to form the Halton Action Group to voice the concerns and opinions of local residents. First point I'd like to make is that the location of this incinerator is very close to local housing. In fact, there's plenty of houses within 100 metres of the incinerator site. As you can see here, we have houses which are very close to the proposed incinerator.
I think we have enough of those sort of industries in this area. We don't need any more, to be honest. Especially with most of the waste that we're going to be burning there is going to be coming from outside this area. It means more road traffic and everything. Yeah, I don't want it.
Are you aware about the potential implications of the smoke that's coming out of the stack that contains?
Aware of some of it, yes, not all.
Dioxins, heavy metals.
Yes,
yeah. What do you think about that? How do you feel about that?
It's a very, very polluted area already, as I say. We have enough of those sort of industries in this area. I think just because we're already polluted, I don't see any reason for us to take any more.
Obviously, these incinerators are not isolated industrial facilities. They're usually, like Ellesmere Port, within the petrochemical industry. But if we just look at Ellesmere Port, that has got the highest level of infant mortality for infants 1 year and under. That means more children die before their first birthday in Ellesmere Port than in any other town in the UK. Now, of course, we can't pinpoint directly the incinerator, but when you look at what an incinerator emits, there's no way can you say it's not the incinerator.
The building of this plant could affect thousands of people in the Halton area. In the local area, there'll be people whose houses will lose value, and so that's one effect of it. Economically, they will suffer. But downwind of the incinerator, there'll be thousands of people who are likely to be affected by the plume of smoke that comes from the chimney. Now, these will be long-term effects, and it's already been known it can be take many years for ill health to be noticed. But certainly many studies have shown that downwind there are an increased number of ill health incidents, which statistically suggests that it's to do with the incinerator. The incinerator will burn household waste, and every year it's proposed to incinerate 850,000 tonnes of material.
How do you feel about trains delivering waste that come past your house in the middle of the night, big trains full of? I mean, do you think that might be a disturbance for you?
It works for a lot of people, I think, yeah. Mm. Especially the elderly, really, infirm and that, yeah. But so you can feel it, the bump of the rails and that.
So the issue for you would be the vibration?
Vibration, yeah.
You're concerned about the vibration issue?
Other than that, well, this, as I say, it only needs one accident life and it's a serious problem for a lot of people. But then you've got the added problem you're talking about, the incinerator. Don't like the idea.
How do you feel about that, the incinerator?
Don't like the idea of it.
You're quite close to it.
Yeah, it should be out in the wild somewhere, but it's interfering with nobody. You never know what they put in and what comes out the fumes and that.
Yeah. Are you concerned about smoke from the incinerator?
Well, I don't know how it's like. They haven't started yet. It's not there yet, is it?
They say it's going to be the biggest incinerator in Europe, I think.
I don't fancy it anyway. I'd rather be somewhere else.
Another concern we have is that the toxic ash, which is a residue of incineration, has to be transported through Runcombe by lorry to the dumping site at Randall Island on the River Mersey. If any of this material, toxic material, is released during transportation, this also could affect local residents' health. And also, when it's stored at Randall Island, if there's any leakage of this material into the River Mersey, this could also cause a pollution problem.
The other problem with landfill sites, of course, is that rainwater percolating through the site generates leachate, which is a contaminated liquid. If the engineering of the site isn't adequate, and it's very difficult to engineer these sites for very long-term protection, and that can leach out into local groundwater or surface water, and then present a risk to local drinking water supplies or to people that are exposed through, for example, swimming in streams or drinking water locally.
Another problem associated with incinerating household waste is that this plant will actually generate 650,000 tonnes of carbon dioxide, which is a greenhouse gas. And at a time when we're trying to reduce the carbon footprint in the country, this incinerator will actively be generating carbon dioxide for the next 25 years. There are, however, other alternatives to incineration, for instance, anaerobic digestion. And Halton Action Group would like to see a review of incineration versus these other less polluting alternatives. If this plant is built, we think it will actively discourage councils from promoting recycling, in that here in Halton they will need as much refuse as possible to keep the plant running, and especially refuse which contains plastic materials with a high calorific value. Therefore, we think this is a negative step in the promotion of recycling in the community.
Ineos not made you aware that they're going to build a waste?
No, I don't.
Europe's
think.
Biggest waste incinerator down the road.
Whereabouts?
Just down where the old plant is there, where the
chlorine
plant is, yeah.
I see, yeah.
Just down there. You're not familiar with it, no?
No, I haven't.
Well, basically, they're going to build Europe's biggest waste incinerator plants, burning, waste, basically. And your house backs onto the railway line, doesn't it?
That's right, yes it does.
So basically,
all of their houses back onto the
line. Yeah, they're proposing to feed it with 850,000 tonnes of waste, which they're going to transport by rail.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, yes.
Via
yeah.
your house.
Yes, I have heard about that, yes. Seen it in the paper, yeah.
How do you feel about that? Do you think it might be an issue for you? I mean, with
well, I don't know. If it's going to be noisy at night, it will be an issue, yes, definitely.
How do you feel about the dust, and the smoke and stuff? That's because you'd be quite close to it.
Yes, yeah, we will be. Yeah. Yeah. Have to see. How
have you heard what's in that dust?
No.
What's in the smoke? Dioxins and heavy metals. And,
oh yeah.
I mean, we've been told that that chimney stack that's going to be there.
Yeah.
You know that smoke can ground round this way here. Mm-hmm. And all those poisons that's in that smoke could potentially be coming through your windows. And how do you feel about that?
Well, I have to just wait and see.